Hi guys, Omar here with the Samsung Buds and my S10.
Before I forget, subscribe and also hit the bell icon to be notified of any new videos that I post.
So once you've opened the cradle, it will start to recognize that the earphones are in use, give you the battery info, all that kind of stuff. Now, if you don't get this message to say there's an update or check an update, you just scroll down into About Earbuds, and then you go into Update Earbud Software, and then you hit Download and Install, and that's what we'll do here now. Obviously, it'll check for updates, it'll download the relevant updates, and then it will install them. It will only do it once the cradle lid is up. So if you have it down and you're trying to update, it won't do it. So now it's going to download 1.32 megabytes worth of update. It gives you like a summary of what's new. So stabilized Bluetooth connection through added fixes, fixed incorrect earbud level indicator, fixed ambient sound menu display error. So these are issues that would have happened in the previous software version, and then obviously when you download it, it shouldn't happen again. The other thing is that once you've installed the software, you may notice that some of your settings have gone to a default or whatever they were before you set them up, so you might need to roll them back. I don't know why this happens. I don't know why Samsung don't have some sort of profile where it stores those settings and then re-enables the previously set up, the previously used settings once the software has been done. But whatever, it may mean that once you've updated the software, you have to go back and maybe set up your ambient sound, the level of ambient sound that you've set up before, or something of that nature. Obviously, while it's being updated, you won't be able to use the earphones because obviously the software has been updating, and that's what connects and makes the connection and sends the music over to the earbuds themselves. So just keep that in mind once you've done it. And obviously I'm at 37% now, so I'll come back to you once it's at 100%. When you're updating the software on the earbuds, don't think that it's downloading or installing or whatever. You can close the lid to the cradle, because if you do, it loses the connection and then you have to start all over again, including downloading the software. So I would advise obviously to leave the cradle as like that with the lid up, and then that would mean that once it's done all the downloading and installing, you won't obviously need to start again. So once it's finished downloading, it'll basically say that your earbuds will disconnect from your phone when the update starts. Once the update is complete, your earbuds will reconnect to your phone automatically. So we'll do that now. We'll hit OK and it should start to install. I don't know whether we're going to get a notification to say it's installing, but I guess the only indication would be that they'll start to they will automatically reconnect once the update's done, which is a shame really, because it would have been nice to have like a progress bar of the install and then you're 100% sure that the install has been done. But I guess we just have to wait now until, so here we go, so they're reconnected. And the way I always do it is I always go back into the update and then I just do another check, and it should come up with, you know, your earbuds are all up to date or something like that, like this. You're already using the latest software, which is good, and we'll just leave things as they are. So that's how you update the software on the Samsung Buds. Thanks for watching guys, and I'll see you in the next one.